CW's The 100 series explores human nature to the full extent. It hooks the fan early with its grim look into the future of our planet, but it keeps them there with genuine optimism. It is a tale of where humans destroyed themselves over and over again, but also explores our will to survive. Today we are here to break down The 100 story from beginning to end. The apocalypse has come and gone at the start of The 100. Humans fled the Earth to live in space following a nuclear war that left Earth uninhabitable. Or so the main characters think. Human decides to send 100 kids down to Earth to check if it's habitable again because of their diminishing resources. At the time of nuclear apocalypse, there were 13 space stations in space, and they came together to form an Ark, as these 400 people are the only surviving humans. 97 years later, the Ark has become a brutal place to live, where death sentences are handed out regularly to save resources. With time, the resources of the Ark are so diminished that Council decides to send 100 teenage delinquents to check the Earth. Then the 100 children are sent in a dropship to Earth. The 100 face a steep learning curve as they were born in space. Soon they learn that the Earth is not so abandoned, that there are several societies living there who call themselves Grounders. Some are descendants of an end-time cult who live in a bunker, while others live in open, who are resistant to radiation. Then there are Mountain Men, who are made up of high-ranking government officials and rich. All these factions were in a war at Earth, and the 100 becomes another faction in the planet's constant small-scale war. The 100 were attacked by Mountain Men, and half of them were kidnapped, as these people wanted blood transfusion so they can return to the surface. Meanwhile, more of the Ark members came down to Earth, as there is no other choice but to leave and hope for the best. They quickly learn about this problem and form an alliance with the Grounders at the new base called Camp Jaha. They attack the mountain and free all the prisoners, where a lot of civilian casualties took place, because of which Clark Griffin, one of the 100 who led the attack, is given the name as Harbinger of Death. Around this time, we learn that the original nuclear apocalypse was the result of an AI called Ellie, who thought there were too many humans. Ellie survived the apocalypse and has created consumable chips that gives her control over humans and takes them to a virtual world called City of Light. Soon, Clark becomes aware of it and enters the City of Light to flip a quill switch to shut Ellie down. But it turns out that Ellie hoped to use the controlled bodies to prevent a second nuclear crisis, because the abandoned nuclear reactors are about to melt down and explode, causing another radiation explosion. Then a bunker large enough to take 1200 people is discovered. A conclave is held to see who will take the bunker. Octavia wins the conclave and invites 100 people from 12 remaining clans to live there. A small group of Ark members were cut off and went to a small ship to back to space. By the end, Clark creates a serum with the help of her mother, which gave her the black blood, because of which she survived the second apocalypse. 6 years later, a mysterious ship appears in Earth's orbit. It turns out to be a prison colony transport ship, which was sent to mine asteroids before the first apocalypse, and the prisoners took control of the ship. Back on Earth, the bunker has devolved into a ruthless place, where one clan took control of food supply, which led other 11 to revolt, who now call themselves One Crew under Octavia's leadership. On the surface, Clark discovered a small valley untouched by radiation and also a child who has the black blood, and Clark raised her as her own. One Crew came out of the bunker and rushed to the valley to take it from the prisoners. A war breaks out between two sides, and the prisoners bomb the valley, destroying the last bit of inhabitable land on Earth, because of which what's left of One Crew and the children of Ark head back to space. They discovered that the other ships were launched to colonize far-off planets. Then they induce cryosleep for 125 years to reach the planet called Alpha. They begin descending and make camps, but quickly realize that Alpha is not so empty as their scans showed, a mirror of Season 1. Alpha is ruled by Primes, whose order is threatened by Children of Gabriel. The Earth colonists have landed in the middle of yet another war. Over time, the Earth colonists learn that Primes are the descendants of 12 original colonists who have kept themselves alive for generations by transferring their minds into host bodies. The Children of Gabriel are the followers of the 13th colonist who left the City of Sanctum over moral objections. The Earth colonists wipe out the Primes and goes back to their ship. Then the colonists discover a mysterious stone that acts as a bridge between worlds. which was created by aliens several thousand years ago. Several people escaped through the portal and others attempt to create a peace on the newly remade Alpha. Season 7 is where the people of Alpha takes on the newer planet people. That was the explanation of the timeline of CW's The 100 until now. Thank you for watching the video. Like and comment with your predictions. How do you think The 100 will end?